great, man.
I'm so happy. I'm so happy you're here.
Yeah.
They're so happy you're here. And, you know, tomorrow is our 1-year anniversary of the show, and you are a very unique guest on the show because this all happened because you sort of announced on social media you wanted to be on the show. And then when my Twitter feed blew up, a bunch of people kept saying, gotta have this guy. No, it was great.
I really wanted to do the show because I have been a fan of yours for a long
time. That's very kind.
Thank you. And so I announced on January 2nd that one of my goals for this year was to appear on the show. And then I think within 3 or 4 days, the publicity department at the CW got an email from you guys saying, here are the following dates. Tell people to stop sending Twitter messages.
It worked. It was a full hostage situation. Now, I'm a little worried that you've accomplished your goals here in February.
That's
Do you
right.
have other things that you can try to accomplish the rest of this year?
I'm just starting to think of what they are.
Okay.
I don't know quite yet.
Great.
But your Twitter feed will be the first one to find out.
Thank you very much. Thank you very much. This is also, I'm very excited about this because one of the things you said was if you were on the show, you have a story about how we met. I will admit, I'm just gonna come and say, I do not remember us
No,
meeting.
I wouldn't expect you to remember this. I went to the Golden Globes in 2013, and it was just an experience that was just rife with missteps. I was sitting at a table with the Big Bang Theory.
Sure.
But I'm by myself, right?
Gotcha. So it's like 9 Big Bangers and you? Okay.
And they did. I mean, they were pleasant, but realistically, if there were 9 Arrow cast members and one person from Empire, I'd be like, what is that person doing here?
Also, when you have, hey, 9 nerds, here's a super handsome dude in a superhero show. Anyway.
So it's right before the show, and it was the first year that Tina and Amy hosted.
Sure.
And you helped them with some of the writing.
I did.
Correct?
Yeah.
So I saw you. And I immediately went up to you because you were still on SNL at the time to tell you that my dream is to one day host Saturday Night Live. Except that. Thank you. Thank you. They approve.
Yes. But here's the thing, Lauren's not on Twitter, so what's your move now?
Oh, boy. I went up, it's funny you should say that. I went up to you to tell you this, except it didn't come out like that. It more came out, hi. Mr. Myers, Steven, SNL, please.
Yeah.
And you actually finished my sentence and then very politely excused yourself because Tina and Amy were about to go live in like 9 seconds.
Yeah. I'm so sorry I didn't remember that.
That was not my biggest mistake of the entire night.
Oh, really? You have more?
Biggest mistake of the entire night was I was sitting at a table with 9 people that I didn't know, so I had a bunch of champagne and I excused myself, and as I am standing at a urinal, I just hear thunderous applause, and then I hear someone start to speak, and I said, is that? And Mandy Patinkin is standing next to me. He goes, yeah, that's President Clinton.
Wow.
I came back to the table, and he came to the same side entrance that you did, and all these Big Bang were showing off their pictures with President Clinton.
Wow. And all you had was a bathroom selfie with Mandy Patinkin.
That's right.
Weird.
There was an Inigo Montoya crossing swords joke to be made, but I didn't make it.
And now you're Canadian.
Yeah.
And this, you actually have a pretty fail-safe approach to Canadian celebs, which I think this is you've got to figure it out.
If a celeb is wearing, or anyone, because it's not just celebrities, is wearing their Order of Canada pin, I walk up to them and I say, hello, Mr. or Mrs. My name is Stephen Amell. I'm Canadian. When did you receive the Order of Canada?
Yeah.
I've only not done it once, and it was a couple of months after our failed run-in with Lorne Michaels.
Now, you could have, because Lorne wears it all the time.
He was wearing it when I saw him.
Yeah. We were actually at, I was at the Vancouver Olympics with Lauren.
Okay.
And we were walking in, and everywhere you go at any Olympics, you have to get through security. And I remember Lauren was so upset they made him put his, like, BlackBerry in the thing because I really felt like he was like, but what's this for? I was like, well, you don't just, like, wear a button and just get to walk through security.
I think Lauren Michaels does.
Yeah.
Except at the Olympics.
Except at the Olympics.